Hello, everyone, and welcome back to a very special specimen spotlight. So this is quite surprising. I looked up from reading my book after dinner to see a raccoon on our deck. So this is the very first raccoon that I have actually ever seen in the wild in person. I'm not sure if you could call the back of my deck in the wild, but this is definitely the first raccoon I've ever seen. So up and close and personal outside of any sort of educational or zoo setting. And it was really exciting. He was so much bigger and so much fluffier than I thought raccoons were, and also a lot stouter. But it was very exciting because I looked up thinking that I saw a large squirrel jump on the deck to see what kind of bird seed we had put out, and it actually wasn't a large squirrel, it was the raccoon. So I shouted up at Chips that there was a raccoon on our deck, and thank goodness he knows the drill. Before I could even get upstairs to try to grab my phone, he was leaning out the window recording this little guy for us. So I was very, very excited, and we were very excited when the raccoon decided to climb the tree outside of our window because he got really, really close and he looked so adorable and he looked so confused at watching us and realizing we were almost eye to eye with him. So it was a lot of fun. The raccoon didn't do any harm. He just came by and was kind of sniffing at the birdseed that was on our deck. And then he decided to shimmy up the tree and groom himself for a little while. And Chips and I were actually really surprised by how fluffy he was and how mobile his nose was. It was twitching all over the place. It really seemed to move very independently from the rest of his body. And he had a much smaller face, almost a much more cat-like face than I anticipated. And his ears were so cute. His ears were definitely probably one of my favorite things about the raccoon, and it really reminded both of us quite a lot of red pandas, which I wasn't really expecting. Vaguely makes sense if you think about their body shapes being somewhat similar. I'm not sure how closely related they may be, if at all, or if it may just be co-evolutionary traits that they happen to share independently, but those ears were so cute, and they reminded me so much of watching the red pandas at the zoo. But surprisingly, the red pandas are actually a lot longer and a lot lankier than the raccoon was. And he was pretty fun. He just climbed up in the tree and decided to give a good sniff with that twitchy little nose of his. And he kept an eye on us and we kept an eye on him. And then he would lean down and he would watch the birds, mostly the cardinals, eat the bird seed off of the deck. I wasn't sure if he was going to try to maybe go after the birds, but he seemed more entertained to just watch them. So we had a really great time, and this was definitely a very entertaining afternoon surprise. And I really love that we live somewhere in Michigan that has so much wildlife literally outside of our back window, even though we are here in the middle of the city. We can walk down into the heart of downtown just a few blocks away from where we live. And the fact that this is a city that has embraced wildlife to the point where they have so many protected parks, they have so many strips of greenways that can provide those green highways that I was telling you guys about in zoo crafting a little while ago, that provide that transportation for wildlife like this raccoon. I love that. I really, really, really love that we live in a city that values those things so much and is willing to make the compromises needed to provide the wildlife with avenues to be able to get in and out of the city without hurting themselves, without hurting the people involved in the city, and that let them flow through in their own little wildlife traffic zones. It's really fun that we live right on the edge of one of those zones too. The raccoon is probably my favorite thing that we've seen in our backyard recently, but we've also seen everything from deer, 4 different species of squirrel. We've also heard rumor of a fox or two, which was very exciting, and we've seen dozens and dozens and dozens of chipmunks. There's all sorts of different birds. I've heard owls, I've heard hawks, I've seen a lot of blue jays, there's sapsuckers and titmice and chickadees and cardinals and so many other species coming all day long to our back deck just after the bird seed. So I didn't anticipate ever seeing a raccoon on our deck, but I definitely will be eager to see what kind of visitors we may have arriving because of the bird seed that we leave out. And I'll try to keep an eye and make sure we don't attract anybody who may not be safe or perhaps desired in the case of a skunk to show up on our deck based on what we leave out for the animals. And as always, you want to try to be considerate that the things that you do leave out for wild animals to enjoy are safe for the ones that live live in that area, and that you're not making it difficult for certain species to be able to follow their normal migratory patterns. But that kind of very serious foo-faw we can save for another specimen spotlight. For now, I'm going to leave you guys to enjoy admiring the raccoon as he continues to groom himself up in the tree. I thought about maybe cutting this out, but I know some of you guys may be like me and be super excited just to be able to watch their natural behaviors for a few minutes. So please enjoy as the raccoon settles into the crook of the tree right outside of my office window, and I really hope that we'll be seeing him again. So I'll see you guys next time. Bye bye.
What a perfect spot to rest and groom. There he goes. Do you think he's going up or down?
It looked like he was going down.
It did look like he was going down.
Maybe he's hungry after all that grooming.
It almost looked like... Oh, there he is. Down we go. And I was excited about a chipmunk. He's just like a red panda. Now he lives under our deck. What are we gonna do?
Just have a chat. I got video of him when he was first on the deck.
There you go. Goodbye, friend. He's off into the neighbor's yard. They have a dog, you know. It's probably smaller than him, though. All right, he's off on his next urban city adventure.